In this example, we are given that in a transistor circuit, its base current is 105 microampere and collector current is 2.05 milliampere. We are required to determine the value of ammeter current and the current gain alpha. Here you can directly write that we are already given that the value of base current is 105 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere and the collector current is 2.05 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. We can simply get the value of base current gain here, which is denoted by beta and given by the ratio of collector current to base current. If we substitute the values, we can see it is 2.05 into 10 to the power minus 3 by 105 into 10 to the power minus 6. The value will be 19.5. On calculation, you can verify it also. And if we know the value of base current gain, the ammeter current gain alpha can be written as beta upon 1 plus beta. If we substitute the values, this 19.5 by 1 plus 19.5 is 20.5. On calculation, you will get it as 0.95, which is the answer to this problem, as we are required to find the value of alpha. And we know well that also we know the value of alpha is IC over IE. So this implies the value of ammeter current we can get as IC by alpha. Here IC we are already given as 2.05 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 0.95. On calculation we'll get 2.155 milliampere. That will be another answer to this problem. The same can be directly calculated in a different way, as we know IE can be written as sum of collector current and base current. We substitute the values. Here collector current in milliampere can be given as 0.105 milliampere plus base current. Here you can write that collector current we are already given as 2.05 milliampere. And in this situation, base current we can write in milliampere as 0.105 milliampere. So here on adding these two, we are getting it as 2.155 milliampere. That will be the answer to this problem. So either ways you can calculate it.